Hello, Scorpio. This is Tarot Queen Jamila. Welcome to your Wildwood Spiritual Animal Totem reading for 2018. Okay, this is where I connect you possibly with a powerful spirit animal that will be able to help and assist you and aid you on your journey, Scorpio. Make sure that you hit the subscribe button and that you stay tuned. And I'm going to actually make a video related to working with spirit animals, okay, or spirit animal totems and meditation. So make sure you hit the subscribe button and the bell notification. And if you need a private reading or spiritual life coaching or healings, cleanses, chakra therapy. Maybe you need to balance out your chakras. The link to my website is below. Okay. All right. So I am going to just get started for the Scorpio, spirit guides, ancestors, guardian angels. Okay. We want to invoke Scorpio sun, moon, and risings spirit guide. As I go now on my way, I affirm Scorpio's animal totem show itself today. I am thankful for this sight. I receive this gift with delight. All right. Let's see what you guys got. Oh, Scorpio, you guys got the forest lovers. You got the Knight of Bows. You got the fox in the hen house, Scorpio. Oh, my goodness. And then you got the Woodward. Very, very interesting what you guys got. So let's make sure that everything is centered. And yes, it is centered perfectly. All right. So the forest lovers, I feel like a lot of you are at a crossroads. First of all, I feel like a lot of you Scorpios, I feel like your spirit guides are really, really, really trying to connect you with nature. They are really, really, really trying to. Okay. When you look at the forest lovers, major arcanas, like I said, I'm only using major arcanas and court cards for this reading out of this deck. I don't know if I told you guys that before. Okay, the forest lovers are placed at Beltane in May, the festival of rites of spring and the gateway to summer. In this position, they balance the suits of bows and arrows and the elements of fire and air and represent the willing interchange of energy that creates the fertile consciousness. I love it, okay? So the love for Scorpio, for the lovers to come up, I feel like a lot of you, unfortunately, you might be dealing with the fox in the hen house right now. But that's okay, though, because just because a lot of people want your lover, Scorpio, doesn't mean that you're unfortunate. You got that person that everybody wants. So, Scorpio, or either they feel the same way about you, either it's vice versa. Both of you, I feel like you're sort of the same. Both of you are possibly the fox in the hen house. That's why the Woodward comes up. So the Woodward comes up, and so the Woodward is comparable to the strength card. Okay, the strength card is in the position of the wheel is August for the Woodward. So feel like that may be symbolic in some way as far as the time of the year. So the first spirit animal totem that lines up in your reading is the fox, the Knight of Bows. So I love that you guys got that animal. Oh my God, that is so amazing that you guys got the fox. You know, so let's look into this. Okay. Let's look into the fox and the animal symbolism. When the fox trots in as your spirit animal, it's time to tap into your own psychic senses. Fox as a totem animal belongs to those who understand wisdom can be found in humor. Invoke the fox as your power animal when you need help to avoid confrontation. So a lot of you, you know, Scorpios, if you want help in whatever matters that require fighting, or if you want to walk away from a fight, if you're ready to free yourself of that, if you want peace in your life, this is the animal that I feel like a lot of you can work with. If you already work with an animal totem, maybe add this one to it. Hello? Let's tell you more about the fox. Fox symbolism. Lots and lots of, okay, so let's go through this, guys. Okay, so there's a good reason for the old adage, clever as a fox. In truth, these creatures are extremely clever and remarkably resourceful, from hunting strategies to camouflage. The fox gets about the business of living life with sass and class. What's more, the fox is a jaunty critter. Okay. Now, observing them in the wild can help you, is what your spirits are saying. Everything is sort of like a joke for them. So this is when things are being thrown at you, literally, that are just crazy, crazy, crazy. And you really can't take those things seriously, even if it is a joke. Now, if somebody's trying to make a joke of your life, then again, you know what I'm saying? So many myths, Native American comes to mind, designate the fox as a jester or trickster. As you, you guys probably do have a trickster in your life. Fox symbolism in China revolved around the afterlife. Lore has it that a fox sighting was thought to be a signal from the spirits of the deceased. And I believe it, because I believe that Scorpios, I believe that you guys are really heavily associated with the death realm. I believe that you guys have something to do with that. Fox animal symbolism in the Celtic realm. Celts believed the fox to be a guide and was honored for its wisdom. The Celts understood that the fox knows the woods intimately, and they would rely upon the fox as their guide in the spirit world. So the fox animal symbolism and meanings, wisdom, cunning, strategy, cleverness, adaptability, quick thinking. So I feel like they're also talking about whatever struggles you may have, like especially if you have somebody in your life that is sort of messing with you, picking at you, trying to make a joke out of you, trying to embarrass you or something. In Japan, the fox was considered one of the rain spirits as a messenger of the Inari, the rice god. Here, also, the fox symbolizes longevity and protection from evil. So you can use it for protection from the evil eye as well. Okay. In Native American lore, the fox animal symbolism deals with two interpretations. One perspective observes the fox as a wise and noble messenger, and the other views the fox as a trickster playing pranks, or worse, luring one to demise. Okay. Also, observing the fox while it's on the hunt, we see its entire body is pointed like an arrow, straight and tightly aimed. This is a symbolic message for us to set a determined and powerfully focused mindset in order to hit the target of our desires. Okay, so a red fox, and some of you might see foxes, maybe you guys are seeing foxes. Okay. Desire, passion, intensity, expression. So this is what leads us into the woodward, and also that leads us to this other spirit animal that shows up in your reading. Looks like a lioness is showing up in your reading, or a lion, but it looks like a female lion. No, it's a lynx. It's a lion-headed human. So it's the same thing, lynx, but it's a lynx, okay? So you guys got the lynx as your spirit animal totem. And somebody else got the links. I think it was the Libra got the links. So let's go over the links, shall we? There's something you feel very passionate about. There's something that you feel very passionate about, Scorpio. Something that you desire, something that you want. Represents this. Okay, so if you dream of this animal, it represents secrecy. So it could still represent secrets. So it does represent secrecy. This animal coming in represents discernment to peel back the layers of deception and see things for what they really are. Look through rather than right at the object of your attention. Trust this cat to let you see the truth of the matter. So there may be something that you guys want the truth about. You can actually use this animal totem to bring that into your life. And if you guys want to know how to do that, you know, I'm going to be going over that. So, yeah. Alternatively, this big cat is telling you to wake up and smell the roses. You are being deceived by someone, and that someone is most likely yourself. Look to see where you are deluding yourself, Scorpio, with your beliefs. Take the time to analyze the truth of what you believe and reconsider what you value within it. Your truth can always change. This animal also encourages you to be more playful and flexible in your life. Okay? She also pushes you to reach out for more opportunities, break out of your molds, and change your routines. Lynx is also about developing our abilities to see the unseen and silent aspects of our inner selves, discerning truth when faced with adversity. This animal totem means that you are a very patient person. You know how to wait for exactly the right moment to pounce. If you don't, then you need to value, you need to learn that. People love to bring you their secrets because they know you have the ability to keep a secret. Sometimes other people are uncomfortable around you because they know that you see through their little dramas and acts, okay? You have learned to trust your intuition and follow through on your inner guidance. You are playful, yet you know how to fly under the radar of others. You are passionate about all things that interest you. Rarely shows it to others. You value time to yourself. Represents ability, awareness, change, comfort, confidences, intuition, loyalty, passions, patience, playfulness, secrets, self, teacher, trust, truth, understanding, and even wisdom. Okay. So that is going to do it for you guys' animal totem readings. Again, if you want to learn more about working with animal totems, I will be doing videos about that, because this is not only connecting with nature but also the primal instincts of the animals, and then being guided by that and then also invoking that energy into your life is very powerful. So if you guys want to learn more about this, you can contact me at the link below. If you want a private reading, I do offer video readings, phone readings, as well as Skype readings. So you can contact me about that. And thank you so much for watching. Make sure you hit the subscribe button. Love and light, and blessed be.